I have 1000 plus hours of playtime and I still don't have an assault rifle. Let's focus on the Excava, Fallen Hope and Divine Punishment. Two of these weapons are straight up terrible and one is not for everyone, which I will explain later. When it comes to choosing a weapon, I will always check whether the weapon has a decent firearm attack and firearm critical hit rate. If a weapon doesn't have a decent firearm attack and firearm critical hit rate, I will then check if the unique ability is decent enough to boost the weapon's damage or crit, or if it is interesting and fun to play with. I enjoy playing critical hit rate weapons, not gonna lie, simply because it feels good when it crits and the damage is very satisfying. Now, I am not looking for a Colossus Destroyer weapon like the Enduring Legacy. What I'm looking for is a handy assault rifle that I can use for infiltration operation and 400% invasion missions. The problem is, most of the ultimate assault rifles as of right now are just straight up bad or not usable for all Descendants. There is a rare assault rifle, but since it is rare, obviously it doesn't have a unique ability, so it is a no-go. These ultimate weapons have a low critical hit rate, meaning no matter what modules you use, it is not going to deal a decent amount of damage, and the only way to make these weapons viable is by using a Descendant that has an ability to increase critical hit rate. Let's be real, if you are dealing white damage or non-crit damage, it will take a very long time to kill regular mobs and it will take forever when it comes to commanders. It is as if the game is telling me to stick with the Thunder Cage and not care about other weapons. I mean, it is good that I don't have to waste my crystallization catalyst, but it gets boring because I've been using the Thunder Cage since the early parts of the game. I feel like these ultimate weapons are just used for leveling the mastery and that's it. That is their sole purpose. Let's take a look at the Excava. This weapon is special because it is the only weapon that has a designated inversion reinforcement add-on. But even with this add-on, it is still trash. It does have a decent firearm attack, but if a weapon cannot consistently crit, then it won't be that reliable, especially when it comes to 400% commanders that are built like tanks. I like the grenade procs and the effects, but that's not enough reason for me to add sockets to this weapon. All this weapon needs is a little bump in the critical hit rate and this weapon will be usable. Having a 3% base crit and a stacking crit is just not enough. Also, why does it have to be 15 stacks to proc the grenade? Why not 10? Let's take a look at the Fallen Hope. Now, this one has an acceptable firearm attack and firearm critical hit rate of 12%, which can be increased to 21% by adding edging shot and better insight. The problem is that its unique ability trigger rate is way too low. Even at level 4, its explosion damage only has a trigger rate of 40%. This is like a pirated version of Thunder Cage, but for assault rifles. 40% is way too low and it feels so inconsistent. If this is the case, I'm just going to stick with my Thunder Cage, which has a 100% trigger rate. Also, this would have been a perfect weapon for Ultimate Freyna when the game released her because this is a toxic type weapon, but instead they let her have the Ominous Hound, which is a normal tier weapon. It would have looked cool if she used Fallen Hope with a new skin specifically designed to match her theme. I have to say that the developers missed a big opportunity on this one. Lastly, the Divine Punishment. Now, this weapon is actually good, but it only applies for support Descendants. So, this is Eugen's go-to weapon. At level 4 unique ability, this weapon provides 35% defense for 15 seconds every time you buff an ally. Every time you recover an ally's HP, shield, MP, or resources, it grants 12% skill cooldown for 15 seconds. And lastly, every time you debuff an enemy, it grants 10% firearm attack for 30 seconds. I still haven't crafted the remaining upgrade for this unique ability because I just can't be bothered. Playing support in the first Descendant is kind of hard in my opinion because you actually have to have a different mindset. You have to sacrifice a lot of damage in order to support your teammates and that is really hard to do in this game. I just can't bring myself to support my teammates because it doesn't feel fun at all. I will max out the Divine Punishment in the future because my goal is to try and upgrade all the ultimate weapons in the game. There is a big chance that these weapons are going to get a buff in Season 2. If you guys noticed, the developers did change the Albion Cavalry Gun and the Perforator, so there is hope for these weapons. What I really want is a critical hit rate weapon because it feels good when you see a massive stream of critical damage, and that is just how my brain works. I think I'm heavily influenced by Warframe because in Warframe, crit weapons are the best weapons to use and it just hits hard. Also, there is a big difference in weapons with high critical hit rates and low critical hit rates. If you go to the firing range and test a critical hit rate weapon versus a regular white damaging weapon, you will see a massive difference. Also, from what I've noticed, non-crit weapons are usually elemental based type weapons like the Excava. Usually, these weapons have a single elemental damage with an elemental resistance reduction that stacks. These are all good bonuses, but as of right now, they just can't compete with critical weapons. All we can do is wait for November 15 and hope that these weapons are going to get a buff or something, because there is going to be a developer video on November 15 which will probably explain what kinds of contents we are getting in Season 2. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.